Hey guys, so get ready because we are decluttering and reorganizing my entire house today, guys. I'm talking both of my kids' bedrooms, all of the toys all over our house, my desk, homeschool stuff, closets. We're organizing it all. So let's just get started. So first we're going to start in my oldest son's room. I changed up his room a ton because it just was not serving him well. I wanted to display the things that he loves as well as keep them organized. So we got this Pokemon card wall of fame, as we call it, to display all of his favorite Pokemon cards. That's what he's organizing right now. And we also put up this really nice shelf and displayed some of his favorite Pokemon stuffed animals, which are things that he plays with every single day. We also got him some new bedding that went with his decor a little bit better, but also made his life so much easier. This is one of those zip beddings, so literally all you have to do is zip it up when you wake up in the morning and your bed is made, which is so cool and makes life so much easier for a 9-year-old boy. It's also very comfortable and he just loves it, especially that big blanket at the bottom. It's so cozy and he just love sleeping with it every single night. I will have this bedding linked in my description box along with most of the decor in my house if you guys want to go and check it out. Okay, now we're going to move on to the living room. This is our designated play area in the living room for our toddler, and I love having this area. I love having all the toys out here so that he feels like he is with us. He prefers to be around us, and this home is not just about the adults, it's also about the kids. So I like having a designated little toy area in the adult part of the house. What I did differently in this area is I got rid of most of the toys. You guys have probably seen me clean this multiple times in all of my cleaning videos, and it is so much easier now, guys, because I have downsized on the toys a ton, and then I have also chosen some really beautiful quality wooden toys, so it's just a lot prettier over here. It looks a ton better. So as you can see, we have this kind of, I guess you would call it like a couch table or something like that, but I used to have those gray baskets that you see next to me on that stand, and that's where I would keep the toys, but it just allowed for a ton of toys to be out there cluttered up, and my baby didn't really play with them that much. But once I took the baskets out and just displayed some of his favorite toys, he plays with them so much more, and it also just looks a lot better. So while I am cleaning and organizing the house, of course my son is still doing the same. So he is putting up all of his stuffed animals right now. We have this designated spot for all of his miscellaneous stuffed animals. And on his defense, this is due to the toddler pulling them all out. So while he does that, I am tidying up our homeschool bins. This is actually a blast to the past, real quick, to show you guys how I organized this. So I got these amazing containers, I will have them linked below, to store all of his homeschool curriculum for each subject. And what I decided to do is take out anything in this built-in that is not related to homeschool. So like, I took out all of our family board games, and I'm going to put that in a different part of the house that I will show you guys in a minute. I decided to leave this in here because I just thought it was funny. But moving along, I decided to put his core subjects in this side of the built-in. So English, math, history, and science are all on that side. I also took out things like those paper dividers that do have to do with homeschool, but were just not serving a purpose and were just kind of left laying in there and taking up space. So I moved those out and I put them in our garage, where we're making like a designated homeschool area in there as well, which I will share with you guys someday in the future once that is done. But as you can see right now, I can just quickly put these away, which is the great thing about being organized and having a place for everything. Now we are back in my son's room to organize his closet a little bit. I actually have a whole video where I put together those little cube organizers and just really transformed his closet. So I will have that link down below and probably on the screen for you guys if you want to check that out and see the whole transformation. But since it was already pretty organized to begin with, I just had to clean it up. My son had let it get a little bit messy, so all I had to do was just kind of get things back in order. And then as you can see, I decided to move our family board games into his closet, which he actually loves to play board games, even just like on his own. He likes to make up board games, so it really made sense to move them in there. Another thing we added recently is those pegboards holding his hats that you see on the left. I found those in the dollar spot at Target and they have been great. He usually just throws his hats in his closet or in a bin. This way they're kept safe and not being squished or what have you. They're just hanging on his wall and I think they look really cute too. Next up is the secretary desk that we have next to our dining table. This desk has been great. It is what we use to homeschool with. And one second before I get into that, I just have to say that does anyone else just start cleaning even when you're organizing? You can't help yourself. I love our steam mop so much. This steam mop actually came with this extra tool. I will have the steam mop linked down below if you guys are interested in it, but I absolutely love it, and our high chair just really needed a good steam, as well as the floor around the high chair, and this poor guy, the desk, also needed a good cleaning, so I just used my Murphy's cleaning oil that works really well on wood to get it cleaned up. It has like yogurt stains on it, things from our toddler, and so yeah, it just really needed a good cleaning, so I had to stop organizing for a minute and do that. I also got out our cordless vacuum, which we really love, and vacuumed up a little bit. I'm telling you guys, you cannot organize if it's just a disgusting mess. This is like a part of our house that has just been kind of forgotten and really needed some tender loving care. Okay, so back to organizing the desk. I decided that I wanted to make this desk kind of my desk, like my teacher desk in a way, as well as being the desk that my son sits at to do most of his like worksheets and stuff like that. So I wanted to make it friendly for both of us. Right now I am just removing some coupons and some of the junk and throwing things away that we do not need anymore. I actually found one of our history homeschool books that I really like, so I was excited about that. That can happen when you're organizing. You find things that you've been looking for. I also found the cute erasers that I was going to use as like incentive for my son to do well on a worksheet or not complain or something, and then he gets a cute eraser. So I was glad to be reminded of that. Then I just kind of wiped it down, trying to get it nice and clean. I think having a really clean desk is very good for, you know, being able to concentrate. Then I went on to the first drawer, and I actually thought that this looked okay, and I decided to just move on to the next drawer. Now, this one I removed most of the stuff and did not put a lot of it back. I'm going to be putting a lot of that stuff in the garage in our homeschool area. But I did put our portable DVD player, love this thing. I just put the Matthew C DVD that we watch in it so that we didn't have to have the DVD container in there, so it took up a little less space. Then I moved on to the bottom drawer, and in this drawer, the left side is kind of like the junk area of stuff I don't really know what to do with, but that we need to keep. Then the right side has like coloring stuff and stickers for my toddler, so that when I need to get him distracted while we're working on something for homeschool, I can. And then finally, I added my beautiful planner that I love, as well as all of my notebooks that I love to jot down ideas and just lists and different things like that in. The last spot that we are decluttering and organizing is my toddler's room. I actually did a lot of it already off camera, but I thought I'd show you guys anyway. I repurposed those gray baskets and put them in his closet to store wipes and such. I also changed up his bedding a little bit and moved his crib entirely. So I moved his crib from the left side of the room, kind of centered. There was a lot of dead space over there, and so I decided to move it to the right side of the room, so there's no dead space at all. It's just in that little nook, that little corner. And then I took out the cube organizer and moved it into his room. It used to be in his closet with all of those little bins that you guys saw. So I just went ahead and moved it out and put his toys in it, much like I did in the living room. And he plays so much more in here, you guys. I got rid of like 90% of his toys, and yet he spends more time in his room than he ever has because they are toys that are quality toys that he actually enjoys, and they're displayed in a way that he, you know, is enticed to play with them. It's kind of a Montessori type room is what I'm going for, although we don't have the floor bed or anything like that yet. I actually also plan to put some pictures on the wall for him, like close to his height, so that he can enjoy them, and there'll be pictures that he's interested in, like animals. He's really loving elephants, so I'll probably get something like that, but they'll also still be really cute and make a statement as well. So that's it for today, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please subscribe and be sure to click the bell so you can be notified every single time I post a video. And please leave me a comment below. I love to talk to you guys in the comments, and I'll see you next time. Bye.